Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to continue the If I Produced 4, and today we're going to cover Bones from Team Sesh. So Bones' style is more of a visual component. He goes for the kind of VHS distortion effect over his videos, and that's a really cool style. And what I like about music, specifically certain artists, is that they're bringing back the flaws that we used to have in the 90s that we used to complain about. You know, if you taped over something by accident, you had to deal with, you know, audio overlapping on your cassette tape, your VHS, I mean. And, you know, people are starting to bring back those small flaws that made those times so cool. So he's one of the people who are doing that visually with the tape saturation or whatever it's called with the distortions. And his style, he also brings back some styles from the 90s, which is cool. I mean, I think that's, you know, I think that's a cool way to advance things, is by taking specific aspects of the past and using that as a futuristic element. So that's his style. So we're going to go through some key elements and make a track, and I'm going to record a vocal idea to it last. So let's start with the melody. Let's open up Nexus, and we're going to find a pluck sound. So a pluck sound is a sound with a very short decay. It goes dink, dink. You know, it has a very short body. Whereas a piano would go ding, you know, you can play a piano like dink, dink, but you want to look for a pluck synth or some kind of instrument that's naturally known to be plucked, like a guitar, for example. Let's just go to plucked. I'm going to stick with the factory sound so you don't have to worry about any expansions. In Nexus, let's change the skin just to get motivated for this style. Since it's more of a kind of alternative rock style, and I'm saying rock because of the grungy kind of style. So let's do Bill Killed, since it has blood on it. Looks pretty savage. Let's go back to plucked, and let's cycle through, see what these sound like. We don't want anything with a long tail like this. It has a very long tail, and it's also very bright, meaning it has a lot of harmonic activity. We're looking for something more low frequency or less harmonic content. So that would work, and we can manipulate the reverb, et cetera, et cetera. Okay, so let's tap out the tempo. So we're at about 128, which is actually a very common dance tempo. Whoops. X, hit Control S, okay. And let's right click, go to piano roll. And we're gonna start with the melody. So, I mean, you can get as creative as you want. There's no right or wrong way to do the melody. There's no right or wrong scale. For the most part, you want to stick with minor scales. Major scales are going to sound too classical as far as music. They're going to sound very like ABC, you know, what's another, like noggin or Nickelodeon type of sounds. So let's start with G sharp, just a random first note. I'm going to change my snap to grid to a half step. And I just decided to randomly start on G sharp. So let's make this happen. So I'm going to go bum, 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 bum. So notice I'm leaving gaps in the melody. That's extremely important. A lot of people, what they do is dun, 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 and they keep it going. You know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and the melody doesn't have time to breathe. Think of a vocalist. If they're singing a melody, they can't be like, I just want to eat the ice cream. You know, they need to take a breath. I just need to, you know, eat the ice cream. So give your instruments breath. Give them time to breathe. I'm gonna go bum bum. Also, we're using a lot of half steps. This is very common in trap to use a lot of half step intervals, which means we're just going from one note to the note right next to it. I'm gonna go dum bum. So again, the technique here is that half step ending. Okay, that's the signature ending. Now what's happening is the effects are taking over the sound. So let's turn down the delay mix or turn down the feedback. I'm going to turn both down. It's just too much delay ping-ponging. Also, I'm going to add more pre-delay to the reverb so that the reverb doesn't kick in right away. I'm going to turn down the decay time of the reverb. And that gives us a dramatically different sound. Let's pull this down an octave just to see. That's a little too dark. It's too much repetition, so let's clone this. Let's go to our playlist, let's add it in, and let's make the second one unique, which basically is cloning it. Let's go to edit pattern, and we want to kind of make it wrap it up. You know, we don't want to have the same thing going over and over and over again. Don't want to go boom, 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 boom. So what you can do to add tension is just play the same note over and over again. I'm going to leave that note in because I did that by accident. So I'm using this as tension. I'm playing the same note constantly over and over. And you can have these with a small time difference, which is what I'm going to do to be make my own unique style. Let's go to snap to grid, none. I'm going to hit shift right on the top notes so they play a little bit lagged. That way you get to hear both notes. That's just my own little technique I like to do when I have overlapping, two note sections, okay? I'm also gonna turn the mod knob up, which is gonna give the reverb a pitch variation. It's gonna actually create a vibrato to the pitch of the reverb, so I want that sound. Also cutting out low frequencies with the low cut. So that delay is acting like a rhythmic element. So we're bouncing already without drums. To make this easier, let's highlight these. Let's go to the playlist options, go to edit, and then go to merge pattern clips. It's gonna create a new pattern called merge clips, and we can edit all the MIDI instead of worrying about two different patterns. Now I'm gonna change the key that we're in. So I'm gonna hit shift up and down just to pick a different tone. So you would do this if the singer can't sing in that specific key, you would simply transpose the key so that it's easier for them to sing it. Now this sound is a little bright, so let's go back to Nexus. I'm going to add a low pass filter. I'm going to turn on the master filter, change it to LP or low pass, and I'm going to lower the cutoff frequency. We're going to be cutting out high frequencies to only let the low frequencies pass. You can also have this move over time if that's what you want. So let's say envelope. That means whatever I do to this ADSR or attack, decay, sustain, release, that will affect the filter. So I want the filter to go up over time. So I'm gonna pull up the attack and tell the cutoff frequency to go up to that max amount over time. Now the sound is, let me lower it. Now I'm not sure if this is the starting or the minimum point. Every synth is different. Let me see here. Okay, so it's a little bit different. So this is the max value, this is the minimum value. Gives it more of a duck sound, so let's not do that. I was trying to experiment with the sound. I don't want to make this too complicated either, but you can always add an envelope to your filter if that's what you want. I think it's the sound. Now I don't want to get rid of all that work we just put in, but I think we're gonna have to ditch the actual source sound. It's plasticky. There's something about it that's not fitting the mood. So this will work better. Let's just let's add a low pass filter. This has more of a horror type of vibe to it. So sometimes it's just the sound. I mean, it really is the key. And I'm going to leave all the effects on, okay? But it just shows how deep you can go with, you know, Nexus. You can change up the feel of a sound. Now let's add an 808. Let's open our browser. Let's go to busyworksbeats.com. I'm going to open up the 808 Science drums, and I'm going to play them along with the sound so I can hear them in context. I like this one because it's very linear. Let me right click, edit it so we can find the key. Let's go to the marker tab, detect pitch regions. This one's in the key of F sharp. Let's go to our envelope and let's reset the root note and now right click on F sharp. So now when we play notes, it will play the correct note. And let's see here. Let's go to pattern 4. Now I want this to be distorted as well. So you can open up your favorite saturation plugin. Saturation is basically like distortion. Saturation or distortion, doesn't matter, whatever you like. There are a lot of FL Studio native plugins like Fruity Blood Overdrive, Fruity Fest Distort, Fruity, Fruity, I did a video on this, Fruity Wave Shaper. I forget the other one. There's another one, Fruity Squeeze. Okay, so there are a lot of options for you just off the default plugins. I'm going to use Decapitator in this case. So they all give you a different harmonic structure, but I'm going to punish this or put it on basically distortion mode. And we're going to program a bass line. So let me add this into the playlist so we can hear it as we go. This is very long, so I want the 808 to kind of ride out and just hold. Then I'm going to go boom, 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 something weird at the end. Using this high octave so I can hear what's going on. So let me start from here. I know this is a little abstract until we hear it in context. So I like a lot of octave play, so I'm going to use a high F then a low F or an octave lower. So I want to go bum bum bum. So you can do whatever you want. That's just my style specifically. So the last note, this is a half step above A sharp. Okay, so we're going from A sharp to B. So this is creating that tension that we use in trap music a lot. Excuse me, in horror music, using half steps. So that's why I used B as the last note. So we're creating tension to lead back to A sharp. Let's add some cymbals. Go to busyworksbeats.com. Let's load up X drums. We're going to pull up some crash cymbals and maybe even a hi-hat. We might go with a hi-hat this time, but it's very minimalistic. All we have to do now is just maybe add a change-up section where I'm going to add a guitar for a little more of a ballad or moody sound. And we're going to add like a sound effect called a whine, W-H-I-N-E. And then we're going to add a vocal melody towards the end so you understand the whole gist. So let's add a cymbal in here somewhere. We need a snare as well, duh. We need kicks and snares, so we'll figure that out in a second. I'm not gonna introduce cymbals for a while, so I'm gonna let the beat build. Let's grab a hi-hat from X drums. hi-hat X. We're going to do the very basic hi-hat pattern because we're sticking to like 90s techniques, which is to do tit-tit-tit-tit. You know, back then they didn't have hi-hat glitches and all that type of stuff in their music. Find a kick that can squeeze in. Now there's one kick that I know is great for laying on top of 808s in the X drums at busyworksbeats.com/X. There's a kick called Kick IH, and this sits right on top of 808s without clashing. And it cuts through. So it's usually a go-to when we have a lot of 808 doing the majority of the work. And we need a snare. Let's see. Maybe snare CF here. And let's program in some drums. So I'm gonna do boom, ch, boom, boom, ch, boom, boom, ch. Very basic. I'm not even gonna change up the drums too much. I'm keeping the hi-hat nice and loud. I pull it down a little bit. So here's where I want to introduce a guitar strum. It may or may not work. I'm trying to blend in two different songs of his. So I'm trying to give you a bigger picture of how you can expand it into your own style. It may or may not work because this is like a science experiment. It hasn't been done before. So let's open up Omnisphere. You can open up any plugin that has your favorite guitar sound. There aren't too many good guitar libraries out there, in my opinion, for a good price at least. There are some for maybe for $600, but I mean, you know, you can get a real guitar for like $150, plug it in, and get a better, more realistic sound. So it's up to you how you like your guitars. Let's go with a nylon guitar. And I'm going to run it through some chorusing. Now this one has a pretty long tail, so let's go to the effects. I'm going to turn off any echoes and any delay, any reverbs that are already built into the effects tabs. And you also want to check tab B and tab A, because sometimes they'll have effects on those. Let's see if we can blend in a guitar dual melody in here somewhere. Now here I'm going to let the notes overlap. I may change the octave, that's why I'm letting them kind of overlap a bit. So I'm gonna go ding, 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 ding. The reason I'm clicking on these notes is to copy the length of the note so I don't have to keep cutting it. Again, half step, this is the horror technique. Specifically in trap music as well. A lot of half steps, notes which are right next to each other. Then I'll go boom, 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 boom. Hopefully I can remember that. Okay, great. I did remember it. And I'm going to drag these notes out towards the end. I'm going to do it the sloppy way because I didn't want to forget the melody before it escaped my mind. Okay, so let's start adding effects to this guitar so we can make it more eerie. It is eerie in the melody, but let's make it more eerie with effects. So I'm going to start with chorusing. Let's go to modulation, analog chorus. I really like this effect in the newly updated Omnisphere. Now also, this guitar is two on the grid, so let's go to the wrench tool in FL Studio. Let's turn up time shift. This is going to push the MIDI a little to the right without actually moving the MIDI. So what it's doing is saying, instead of playing F right on the grid, we're going to move it over a little bit. So this is what it would look like if, you know, with time shift, but it doesn't visually change the MIDI. I'm going to add a little amplifier in here just to make it sizzle a little bit. Sound a little more buzzy. There we go. Now I'm going to run that through reverb. So let's set up our aux reverb on track 100. We're going to set up what's called a dedicated reverb. On track 100, we're going to set up what's called an aux reverb. So let's open up reverb options. I really like Altiverb for this because it gives it a realistic environment. You can also use FL Studio's Fruity Convolver, which comes with FL Studio. I'm not sure. Let me see here. I have the producer edition, so it comes with the producer edition. It's the same exact thing. Okay, you can load up different environments in this plugin and treat your sounds as if they're running through those environments. It's called an impulse response based reverb or convolution reverb. So we go over that in the Mixing Academy, but let me choose an environment, and I want to go to an opera theater. Just clicking on random stuff. I like to experiment. It's kind of like Omnisphere. There's so many places. Sometimes you got to switch it up. So I'm going to send this guitar. I'm going to click on track 7. We're going to go to the bottom right here and left click and drag the amount up to send it a duplicate of the signal to what's called an aux track. And that aux track has dedicated reverb effect on it. So it's only playing the reverb sound. So here's what the guitar sounds like. Now I'm gonna play it before and after the reverb. Here's before. Here's after. It just gives it, you know, a personalized attitude. Okay, so we're going to do that for each sound except the 808. That's why I usually don't like reverbs in built-in plugins. So I'm going to take off the reverb on this specific sound and run it through our own reverb. This way we have a little more control. Let's do that for every sound. Even the hi-hats. It just gives everything a new dimension, a new space to kind of sound in. Some kind of haunted kind of whine sound. It could be a sample, but we're going to create our own. Let's go to Nexus again, just since we're already on the Nexus thing. Let's go to single layer leads, and I'm going to pick on, let's just do brass. I'm going to go to mod. We're going to turn legato mode on under portamento mode. So when I play notes, it will pitch bend. And I also want to change what's called the pitch range, PB range, or pitch bend range to 12 so that it will bend an octave. And we're going to change our pitch bend range here as well to 12. And I'm going to play the root note of whatever we are playing, which is, I think, A sharp. Let's go to piano roll. Let's just type in an A sharp. And it doesn't have to be this long either. I don't know why I drew it out that long. It's going to be, okay, snap to grid, half step. It's not going to be one bar long. It's going to be one beat long. Okay, and then we're going to go to the pitch wheel, right click, create an automation clip. So it creates a pitch bending clip. Let's zoom in. We're going to right click the beginning, copy the value so we have it, and right click a point to the end, then right click and paste. So a pitch bends according to however you set up your automation. I'm gonna delete the excess. Now your goal here is just to make it sound creepy. So you wanna try different octaves, like high octaves, low octaves. Kind of like the high octave. Also, I'm gonna give it a little more reverb and a little more mod envelope for the reverb, which means it's gonna do that pitch bend thing. On the grid, so let's go to the wrench tool, turn that time shift up so it doesn't hit right on the grid. So it's like, dang, you know, when the cymbal's hitting, it's too much hitting at once. Well, I was going to turn it down in the mix. Adding your vocal idea to the song. That's why I say vocals are so important, as well as mixing. Okay, this is just raw material. You know, I show you how to get started so you can keep pushing the envelope. Don't take these 20-minute videos as like this is the, you know, the best the beat can sound. I try to give you a better song demo after I record the vocals and do a little mixing, but even then, that's not as much time you could spend making it, you know, really unique. So you really want to push these foundational elements and techniques and start, you know, keep pushing it with the other techniques. So, you know, songs take time, okay, but you can get through them quickly as well. So let me add a vocal idea. I'm going to play the beat twice and then I'm going to go back, add a vocal idea, and then mix it so it sounds a little more professional, and then you'll hear that towards the end of the video. The musicality behind this, how we created melody and how we created the guitar parts to go along and the 808 to match so seamlessly, you want to learn music theory. That's going to help you get into multiple genres easily. So go to busyworksbeats.com/music theory. And if you want a course specifically on melody, we have a course called Melody Magic, which goes over the in-depth parameters in melody. It's way more than what we have in music theory in a day. It goes into melody to the core. So I'll leave both links below. Just click them if you want to learn more. Thanks for watching. In the next section, we're going to introduce the song demo idea, which is I'm going to record vocals and I'm going to mix the song to a decent level. So you can hear how you can take this raw material and turn it into something presentable. Thanks for watching today. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.
Team strong, money long, hella charged. On the West Coast, getting hella charged. Turned up, yeah, we 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 turned up. You know we ghosted when we haunted on the scene. I never tried to stack the money, but we always stacking green. You mean I'm on the scene, and yeah, I'm dipping in the beam in case they want to catch the beam. I'm riding off, I'm in the beam, I guess. So what you holding up the vest, that mean you holding some. See what you holding up the tech, that mean you holding some. But you ain't grown to none, this is a man's game. And you can stand down, or you can catch the flame. Understand my name, C-Bones is what I'm taking them to. And if you got a problem, you'll be the next one too. So don't come step to do, if you ain't repping crew. If you ain't strapped in, do not come wreck the fool. Turned up, yeah, we hella charged. Turned up, yeah, we hella charged. Turned up, yeah, we hella charged. Turned up, yeah, we turned up.
Create complete compositions with comprehension. Master music theory. Visit BusyWorksBeats.com/music theory for your free bonuses and free music theory tutorials. Professional mixing secrets finally revealed. Get 3 free videos straight from the new Mixing Academy complete course package at BusyWorksBeats.com/Mac. Want to learn how to make beats like the pros? Join now for free at BusyWorksBeats.com and learn the secrets of the pros.